Now at noon, one of San Francisco's most recognizable areas endangered. A new report says that the elements are leaving the Embarcadero vulnerable. Good afternoon. I'm Kenny Choi.
And I'm Michelle Griego. San Francisco's Embarcadero is on the latest list of America's most endangered historic places. KPIX 5's Jackie Ward joins us live to explain how earthquakes and rising sea levels are major factors. Jackie?
Michelle, news of those threats isn't a surprise to anyone who works at the Port of San Francisco. A lot of time and money has already been put into plans for worst-case scenario. The interim director of the port tells me that being on this list reemphasizes a call to action. The Embarcadero is one of the most iconic places in San Francisco. Whether you're running, taking the dogs out for a walk, or riding alongside it during your commute, it's a place that a lot of people appreciate.
It's a fantastic sort of view on the city, all the people of the city, what's going on. You've got the view of the bay, you've got the view of the buildings. It's always busy.
Some tourists, and they said like, oh, you're lucky to live here. And I said, yeah, you think so? So, and they said, this is amazing. This is a magical place. I said, oh, thank you. I live in a magic place.
It's hard to imagine what this city would be like without this treasure. The National Trust for Historic Preservation just named the Embarcadero one of the most endangered historic places in the country.
It means that this is a really important historic resource for the people of the city and county and of the state to enjoy.
Elaine Forbes is the interim director of the port. She says the 3-mile seawall sits on mud, meaning the Embarcadero will fare less well than once predicted in the case of an earthquake.
And we are pencils down working on a planning study to make significant investment in this infrastructure to improve its seismic stability.
And according to the 2012 National Research Council study, by the year 2100, the tides may be 66 inches higher than they are today.
But it's not just the San Francisco Bay, it's the entire Bay Area region that needs to come together to address sea level rise.
Prior to being put on this list, the city had already budgeted $8 million over the next 2 years to assess the seawall's condition. In San Francisco, Jackie Ward, KPIX 5.